and see the next chapter. So thank you. Thank you, Greg. We're so pleased that you could be here for this announcement. The Jefferson County Commission played a major role in attracting DC Blocks to our community. And now I'd like to welcome Jefferson County Commissioner David Carrington for his remarks. David?
I want to ask my fellow commissioners to join me. Yeah. Hello. Tony, come on up.
You ever had that moment when you couldn't find your prepared remarks? What a great way to start Innovation Week with a major announcement. But before I get started, I want to say, just take a point of personal privilege. I first met Secretary Canfield in October of 1999 when fewer than a dozen concerned citizens showed up to discuss how we could make our community better. I've observed Greg closely as a fellow counselor and as a state representative and from afar. You know, 20 years later, Greg, I can see your fingerprints all throughout this state of ours, from Google to Facebook to Airbus to Toyota Mazda to Autocar to Amazon, and now to DC Blocks. Greg, as a point of personal privilege again, I want to personally take a moment to publicly thank you for all that you've done for our state and our community. Next, I'd like to recognize Mr. John Harris. Where are you, John? There he is, right there. I've gotten to know John a little bit over the last 3 or 4 or 5 or 8 years. He's a neighborhood president here in Titusville. He had a vision that this land would be used for economic development. And he diligently worked with Commissioner Brown at the county to make this day a reality. And I just wanted to thank you, John, for what you've done for not only this community, but for our metro area. Thank you. You know, it's bad when you start to mention names because you're going to leave someone out, but I'm going to give it a shot. There are so many people that played a significant role in this announcement. You know, the company, of course, my fellow commissioners, county manager Tony Patelis, Ted Von Cannon and the Jefferson County Economic Industrial Development Authority Board, Rick Davis and Alice Reeves worked personally on this project. I know the mayor is here. There's the mayor and his staff who worked so hard for that, and particularly Josh Carpenter for all that he did, the city council, the Birmingham Industrial Development Board, and so many others that I'm sure I left out. I apologize in advance, but this has been truly a team effort, and it takes a team to land a project that has the potential of almost $1 billion in economic impact over the next 10 years. So give yourself a On a cold winter day last January 24th, several of us met, right, about 50 yards over there, to discuss the possibility of selling DC Blocks 5 acres for a single data center. Over the course of that conversation, the vision of an expanded technology and innovation campus began to emerge. Today marks the formal beginning of a project that could result, as you've heard, of $785 million worth of investment, capital investments over the next 10 years. The impact on our schools is going to be immeasurable, not only for the encouragement of our students, but quite frankly, for the ad valorem sales tax that it will generate. DC Blocks will be a tremendous asset to existing companies throughout Jefferson County and a tool to attract new companies here. This takes Birmingham's thriving innovation ecosystem beyond its usual physical boundaries of the city center and extends it into an area that will only strengthen our core. Critical IT infrastructure investments of this type into our community will most assuredly fuel economic development, spur innovation, and enhance our region's technical capabilities. So Jeff and Mark, thank you for the confidence you place in our community. We stand ready and willing to make our joint January 24th grade a reality. Thank y'all.